I take for my sermon today sin. Sin, and in particular, carnal sin. Carnal sin, and the pleasures of the flesh. There are many among us who harbor unclean thoughts of such sinful acts, but I say to you that wretched indeed is the man who surrenders to his will and commits them. Who is this man? Does such a heinous and guilt-ridden individual shelter within the respectable portals of this church? No, he does not. No, there is nowhere he can shelter. Nowhere he can escape the awesome wrath of Providence for his fatal indulgence in that most cardinal of the crimes against his fellow man, adultery. Tempted by the heady salacious delights of extramarital fulfillment, would dare to defy his maker by descent into fornication and erotic sexual licentiousness. What manner indeed? What manner of dread sinner is it who says yes to the lure of Satan, to sink wickedly into Lucifer's most loathsome and damnable physical passions and desires? I say to you today that this man cannot escape foulest retribution, nor penance to flout man's most sacred of laws, to invade his most holy institution, to defile the very sanctity of the bond of marriage. I say to you, this transgressor is damned for all eternity!
Don't you, sir? He's found out!
Oh, ruddy Nora!